there's a claymore from Zelda.
Where's the bathroom?
Right there.
Sorry.
Pause, please. If you can't tell, we're in a different environment. And yeah, we're going to be filming at the park today. You can see the little pond lake in the background. We have Gus here. Hopefully it won't be too loud or too soft. I gotta make sure. Is it focused on me? Can you focus on me? Focus? I think it's focused.
We can get away. Watch face fuse. Ordinary day. All I wanna hear you say, visions are a play, sit right next to you, you.
If you can't tell, I have that song stuck in my head. I'd love to do a soft singing ASMR. I think that would be really fun. What do y'all think?
But I will describe the setting because it's a really beautiful day here today. It's about 74 degrees and a nice autumn morning. There's a little bit of haze outside, so when you look out you can kind of see just like a very thin fog in front of the trees, and we have the lake here in back of us, so there are quite a few ducks swimming around, and you can hear some leaves falling. Some of the leaves have changed colors. You might hear some noise in the background from the cars and some noise from Gus rustling around on the blanket here or chewing some sticks, which maybe will give you some tingles as well. Okay, so I brought a book that I'm currently reading. It's called The Villa and it's by Rachel Hawkins. So we're going to go ahead and flip through some of these pages because I love the way that books sound and feel. So this is a hardcover book. And I'm only about 40 pages in, but I will take you through the book a little bit. Is my book.
case you couldn't tell, this is sparkling water. Oh, you know what we could do? We could do a tracing of your tattoos. She said. Okay. So, this tattoo has two hearts. It's a locket. A locket. Is this Addy? This is Addy. Was the best German Shepherd ever. I loved Addy. This is such a nice tattoo with the little chain. Addy was a big German Shepherd, but she had the best personality. She was the sweetest dog ever. I miss Addy. And then, if we work our way up, 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 then we have this tattoo, this tattoo, this tattoo. It's a little star, diamond situation, very clean line work, just because all pretty tattoos. This is her dragonfly. This is her dragonfly. 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 She has a little bug in her hair. A little bug. Hi, little bug. Little bug. Next to the dragonfly. Touching your arm like that's the focus. Focus, focus. Focus right here. Focus right here. Focus right here. Okay, this one's probably my favorite tattoo. It's a little bumblebee. A little bumblebee. I love bees. I want want to have my own beehive one day. I'd love to raise bees. I love bees, love bees. I love bees. A pretty butterfly. Is this a monarch? Oh, it's a monarch butterfly. You could see the wings, the wings. Let's count. There's 14 little spots. Let's count the other side and make sure it's even. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yay, it's even. That would have sucked if we found out that your tattoo wasn't even right now. And we have another little star. Is this what it is, a star? Do they have names? I like them. I like the stars. I like the stars. Stars, stars, stars. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 points. 8 points on the star. 8 points. And we've got a little hidden four-leaf clover. Side. Let's just make sure that there are four leaves on the clover. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, we're good.
Oh, there's no.
Not the reveal of the dagger. And then we have a dagger. A dagger. A dagger. Is that what it's called? Or is it a sword? It's a sword. 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 What is the meaning behind this one?
This tattoo is actually of a soldier's claymore from Zelda Breath of the Wild, which is one of my favorite cozy games to play. I highly recommend if you like cozy games. So I got this tattoo because I love that game so much.
And we have a little horseshoe, and this one's fresh. It's fresh, fresh, fresh. It's got really deep lines, good line work, and some shading right here. Shading right here. Shading right here. Shading throughout. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's count the dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 little dots. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10.
These are my favorite ones right here. They're so girly. I love them. So one of my favorite things to do on myself to give myself tingles is play with my hair, and one of my favorite types of hair is curly and wavy hair because I love the little kinks that it makes. It feels so good just twirling them on my finger. And Smiles has a lot of curls. So I'm just going to twirl these on my finger. And they're so pretty and wavy. Twirling, twirling, twirling. Massaging the scalp a little bit. Letting the hair fall down her back. Letting the hair tickle her back. And massaging the scalp again. Getting a nice scratch on the scalp. And then twirling the curls on my fingers. And her hair is so soft. And massaging the scalp again. Letting the hair fall on her back. Tickling her back. Now I'm going to put her hair in a braid and talk you through how to braid hair if you don't know, which you probably do, but I'm going to talk you through it anyway. So we're going to take the hair and put it into three sections. One section on the right, one section on the left, and one in the middle. And we're going to take a section on the right, over the middle, take a section on the left, put that in the middle, right in the middle, left in the middle, right in the middle, left in the middle, right in the middle, left. In the middle, right, left, 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 right. And now we're going to do some back scratches, which is one of my favorite tingles. So we're going to scratch, 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 scratch. Thank you.
That is all.